Hello? Maris? Maris? Hello? Maris, John here. Your friends were here on Saturday. They didn't tell me in the office, okay? So I'll just try again later. Alright, bye. They look good. Okay. That's Maris. That's what flags look like. There. Two flags on the car. They're supposed to be heavy duty ones. They've been fashioned that made them fit. And this top holds them on. It clips on so they won't fly off. Okay. It looks like they've been covered in some sort of latex to protect them, but that's supposed to be a heavy duty flag. Anyway, that's it. Waving in the wind. Goes on window. Like that. It's tilted the right way. Going backwards. It's pointing backwards, like on an angle. On the right and the left side. That goes on. I'll ring up. Yes, Keith, please. Yes, John Wano here.
G'day.
The things were here already on Saturday. They didn't tell me. They didn't tell me in the office in the lobby. Stupid buggers. I was looking forward to them. And they said they didn't say.
For the weekend.
Oh well, now my mate's up north. He's got to come down. Somebody's going up to take it, put on his black Mariah car, so he can go 200 miles an hour, so it won't fly off. Yeah. What's that? So what's the material that is? Is it?
That's called poly knit.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, it's a knitted fabric. It's a good one for getting up in the air quickly.
Yes, yes. Poly knit. So I can tell them it's a poly knit. So it should last longer, eh?
It should last longer than what I had before. Yeah. Especially if it's the same way we finished the street banners with the outer edge, it should be a raw cut.
Oh okay.
Yeah.
Oh, it's heavy on the ends and pulls it off, I suppose, in the wind.
That's exactly what happened.
Oh, that's lighter like it is. Oh, no wonder. Oh, that's good to know.
Yeah.
That's
yeah.
Good to know. It'll fly better.
Yeah.
And won't pull it apart.
Yeah.
I see what you mean. Yeah, so you'll be happy with that on his car and displaying everything? Yeah. I just. That's what happened. His son opened the window and the flag went flying off. He's got to make sure to take the lock out. To disconnect the lock so it won't open. And he'll open it. Yeah, so you'll have to make it like that.
Oh, yeah.
But no. This will be the first one you sewed up like that.
Yeah, Normally we put a hymn on the back, but it's just no good. It's just proved to be a disaster.
Oh, okay.
Because they just don't last anywhere near as long.
Oh, okay. So this was like a little prototype for anybody else who wants one.
No, that's how we do all of them now.
Oh, I see. That's how you do them all. Yeah. Okay. So anybody else, though, they can go to you and get one like exactly like this then, eh?
That's right.
I can just lift them off to you to sort out and buy them straight from you. I don't have to necessarily go and get it for people. I only got it for my mate. My mate, he's my chauffeur.
he's worth doing the street work for.
Yeah, yeah. Now, there's only him and Moira Hoffman Russell. She's the one that gave me her whakapapa with the right Rahiri whakapapa up north. All the others have been twisted around. On the iwi Maoris and Ngāti Whātua Ōrākei and Ngāti Whātua Ōkaipara, Mahi Manuka put all the stuff together with the whakapapa and everything with me for the flag, but it was not what it's supposed to be under the British title. It was designed for the Australian. Now, this flag is not a contract to Queen Elizabeth or the government or the Maoris up there. The Maori only came out in 1945 with the war period. This was for only the paramount priest who talks that language between here and Britain. You see? So they're flying it, but it's got no legal in it. That's why I tried to tell them, but they won't listen and won't get anywhere with it until they all come together. It looks like they're going to come together because Rapa Nui, the East Island, they've got their island back now. And Chile gave it back after about 170 years, and they went to Britain to get it back. Now this country will come back with this flag now that I'm telling you. It's all on my Facebook and YouTube with the 1480 videos now, and what's going to happen. So as soon as I take Cook Street, then the whole lot's going back. One shot with this flag. So everybody will be wanting flags after that to be famous.
Hey, tell me, you know that
the
creation is black around
the
box.
There was
a purple one done at one stage. Do you know anything about that?
Not the purple one. The purple is more Ratna.
Oh,
of course. The Ratna, we're trying to put the confederation together with Mohi Manukau in the Kaipara. And that's where the Ngāti Whātua Ōrākei came from, out of the New Auckland province titles.
Yeah.
That the Rogans married into the Manukaus in Kaipara, and they married my Wānaus at Eastgate. They put all the titles together down there in Gisborne. So between the Manukaus, the Wānaus and the Rogans, that's where all the titles came from, and the Russells, Moira Russell, that's my friend on Facebook, she's backing me up all the way, and she gave me her whakapapa book. The Russells put it all together here, so we've got that tied up with this flag, and there's nobody can say anything about it. It's a contract, private, nobody's business. That's the Admiralty. That's what that flag is. The blue is the Admiralty and the sky. And the 8 points is St. Patrick from Belfast, Northern Ireland, where St. Patrick is buried. He's a Catholic and from Rome, but he was buried in Northern Ireland. And that's where the Rogans and the Cosgrove lawyers and the Rogan judges and land agents come from with my family there. So that's my white side there, with all that going on, with me on my shirt that the police pinched and lost the case against me on Cook Street. They lost the case, and they'll lose another one if they don't stay out of my way when I go in and get Cook Street, because that's really a bank fraud. All the banks have been taking money out of people and using this flag. So that Waitangi National Trust is using this flag, and it's not a Queen's flag contract. That's what that flag is, a contract. It's not a normal flag. And that black strip around it, that's the Navy military to protect against pirates. It's a pirate's flag to keep pirates out, and they're making us pirates. You see, the birth certificates, they're worth 100 million. That's what the government here gets, and only gives me 26,000 for my gold card, for my retirement. That's all I've been running this business on, gold card. The whole lot. The whole business, everything, 107 websites on Facebook and all those videos telling everybody how this flag works and how it got duped out. They took the Cambridge down here in Waikato. They took that Tira Waikato Wharehere Manukau. He started off with King George IV in 1820 and sold New Zealand and Pacific Islands as one shot. And then from that, this flag came out of that contract, you see? In King George from 1820, those Hongihika and Te Rawaka Wharehere went to England to learn English and to get some arms. So Hongihika got the muskets. That's what he's still doing now. His ancestors are still doing the same thing now, fighting, instead of doing the contracts. And Te Rawaikato did the contracts, came and he's from Cambridge to Cambridge over there. And but these Ngāti Whātua in Kaipara switched the manuka around into Te Rawaikato, split the name Te Rawaikato and made a female and made all their whakapapa out of a female, and that's where it's gone wrong. And then Te Rawaikato, and then his descendant after 1830, that's when King George the Fourth died, King William the Fourth took over that contract, you see? And then he gave the flag in 20th March 1834 as a continued contract of that Te Rawaikato guy and gave it to Rewherewhere Manukau. That's when these Ngāpuhi fellas switched that as well. They switched the Rewherewhere and made it Rewa into Ngāpuhi. And I'm telling them, no, you fellas duped all those two Manukau Moriori's from Chatham Islands was a country. The British took Chatham Islands as a country and then started from there and came back into New Zealand from there. So they don't know that. They've covered it all up and I've just gone and split the dummy. When Mora gave me her whakapapa, that's intense and showed everything, all the gum trees and all the kauris and everything, and the whakapapa just put all the other ones out. And that's what I'm using now, the flag in her whakapapa. The British title is safer than the Australian Rothschild Banks and Queen Victoria and Queen Elizabeth. That's defrauded everybody in New Zealand and the world for that matter, and this flag will fix it all up. The flag will put it back where it was in the King's Bench and the common people, which is what it is. It's a flag for the common people. And that's what I'm doing. That's what I've been doing for tripping ages. And now it's just about come to a head. Next month, I'm getting these authenticated. And once they come authenticated here in Britain, that's it. For the whole world. So that's why I say lots of people online now start to follow and say, what's wrong with your married people? I said, oh, they just take 180 years to learn what to do with the flag. They should have been using it for what it was meant for, between here and Britain, not flying it around for Maori. The Maori government is the government of Wellington. They're the Maori government. No use trying to make another Maori government because they're using everything Maori. They've created the word Maori and iwi in the government of Wellington in New South Wales. And so that's why it's stupid to go and make another Maori government. That's why everything Maori is falling apart, because of those documents that the government in Wellington have been rolling over under their own jurisdiction and not Britain, where it's supposed to be. And I'm just putting it back to Britain and squaring the books up and make them pay up. Okay, so you can sell lots of flags. Before the Chinese sell them all, they're selling the flags. They're selling the flags, but I'll tell them to go to you. Okay?
Okay,
Keith.
Thank you, John.
Cheers. Bye. There you are. I'm good. I caught them online. Oh, I didn't tell them that I was going to go to Malta and Britain, the 20 flags that I've sent there with Mui Manukau. But that was for the Vatican. That was for the Vatican, see? That was for the Freemasons of the Vatican, that Mui was here. Freemason. Over there, hello. Freemasons. I was taking him to these Freemasons meetings. You know the Freemasons in Helenville? They only take 5 minutes, and 10 minutes at the most to have the meetings all over. You know, they only go there, sign like that, finish. Sign, go. Because they do all their homework at home and in their offices and their businesses. They are called gentry, right? They are the gentry. I've got no problems with that. I've got no problems with Scotland because they know trade and I'm in it for the trade and to make this flag work. I've got nothing against the Freemasons. In fact, I'll make a cut of deal with them and this to put the record straight. The tribal letters, other people have switched it around. But I've taken this out of Mohi Manukau's head. I've put all these tribes together and people have cited them. I've only had this out in the last hui at Tūanga Waka Marae in Epsom. I had it inside that marae and also at Taheke Marae in Hokianga. That's the only time I brought this out, and I put it online before that to show everybody where this flag supposed to work around the world with this flag and Ratana and Mohi Manukau at the same time. We're trying to sell, hard sell this plan to Ngāpuhi in Te Timorai, and it wouldn't work because this is a commercial contract and it didn't go together with Ratana because they had their own way of running business, not this flag. They had their own flag, their own religion. They didn't have St. Patrick's Church. They had their own Ratana Church, our own Maori native church with no Pākehā to run it, but Maoris, the Maoris that are in here. The Maoris, this is not a Maori flag, by the way. The Maoris are flying around, but it's not for Maoris. It's not for Maoris. It is for British citizens here, immigrants who have come, and the natives who signed with this flag to use it for its intended purpose. The Maoris here got mixed up with the Queen, and that's where it's gone pear-shaped with this. It don't work. This don't work in the King's world. It only works in the Queen's world. Alright, you got that? Now, we're going into 250 countries with shares. I might as well get on to that now. The shares of the Māori Total Energy Project will come under the Māori Powerhouse Group Limited Company registered in London. That has 1 billion shares out of the parent company here, Ngā Atua e Wā Aotea Limited, registered in Wellington, New Zealand. That has 1 trillion shares as debt. Okay, all the debt goes into that business here, as the parent company that goes after all the debtors, judgment debtors, and sticks them in that lot in New Zealand, inside Tūanga Waka Marae Native Magistrate Court. Right? That's where all the debtors are going until we have the new Māori Federal State Government building in Cornwall Park, Wantre Hill. Now that building I've got online, you can see it there. I'll see if I can find it online and show you. But it's there, just to have the central government of the world under this flag in 250 countries with 2 representatives from each country. That means 500 members who will be running remote inside that building here in Epsom or Green Lane. Okay? They'll be running remote in that Federal State Building. It's a big building. It'll be worth about $3 billion for that. And it's got lots of space for stadium at the same time, shops and everything. Hang on, I'm just going to ring Horace and see if he's home. No, he's home. I'll give him a couple of minutes. I'm saying this. The federal state government of the world is a dual British New Zealand native paramount chiefs. I'm picking the paramount chiefs, the ones that I can get on with now. The other ones have gone their own way. Bundy has gone his own way. He wants to go and do his thing. And that sort of leaves them right out. I'm I'm doing it this way. This flag is a world flag. It is not just those Maoris. It's not labelled as a Maori flag. This is an international flag for Te Rā Waikato whare, here here in Manukau, and Rewhare for Manukau, the only ones who put this contract together. It is a contract flag of Admiralty in a magistrate court. Not any other court, only a magistrate court. And that's where the whole lot of these people have come adrift, because they were trying to do it without any experience of magistrate courts, banks, and instruments of legal jurisdiction and authority.
Your prepaid account balance is less than $10.
Here we go. He should answer now.
Hello. No one. Take your call. Please leave a message after the tone.
Mr. Morris, pick your phone up. Your flag is here. Hurry up. Open up the phone. Oh, you must be up with Marianne. Okay, your flags are here. You can tell them to pick them up. I split the box open to have a look. They look nice. And the flag has no edges on, so that it won't, that's why it causes them to break. And so it's got a bit of material. It's a nylon, para nylon or something like that. You see it? I wrote it down what it is. It's a poly knit. Material, and so that should last you longer. But the flag stick, I think you better lock your electric windows when people are in the car, and don't let them open it until you get out and open it and take the flag off. So that'll save the flag from running away. So there you go. You have your flags. Okay, that's it. Anyway, back on this international part of the flag for my friend Daryl Pan and those Americans watching, and Renee Powers. They're both trying to save their properties. Well, I think Renee's lost her land and her house, but this will get it back. Okay, I want you, Renee, to put all your documents together ready for me to action with yourselves there and authority. Once I get Cook Street, I'll be kicking into action and doing everything on Messenger or Skype on a call, and do it that way, because I don't want to fly around all over the place. I'm not flying over there. I'll do everything online, and the same with what's his name, Joseph Kinemato. Harvey Joseph Kinemātoa, Paramount Chief, or Chief, in Canada with Raymond Faithful. Those two. The other guy, Johnny Likes, just to stand aside for now, because I didn't like what he was doing with those other two. They've got to learn to talk to each other. I didn't take you off, Johnny. You stay on online, but just take your time. Don't panic. Your turn will come. Yet, but at the moment, I'm confident with Harvey as being someone I can talk to without causing a fuss or bother with anybody else. Where I don't want any animosity amongst people. And this is for everyone. The Moai statue is for everyone. I just made an announcement that Moai has got its country back in Rapanui. I'm happy about that. And also I'm happy that I can now engage with Santi Hitorangi, that my distant cousin will be with me before long to go to England. I'll be putting all that on to go to England with them and the family, and my family with my Filipino friend, to come with me, and Cecile Hoods to go to England with Morris Baker. I won't be taking your money. I prefer not to be mixed up with Wrath in the Church. I've said enough about Wrath in the Church and what they did with Riff Riff and Mother Girl's title, and took it as if they owned it. And that was mischief coming from Maniapoto and Rokawa that stole Referefa Manukau's ancestor, Tera Waikato Wharehere Manukau's land, his native land, and change the names, change everything like how they do, and put their own names on that marae down in Maunga Tautori. Okay, so I wasn't very happy about Rewi, Maunga, Maniapoto, and their title, and Hoturua. We took the Maunga Tautori's land and the Manukau's title. That's why you won't see anything said about Manukau in the Manukau Harbour, trying to take all that law over. It belongs to Manukau because that, its name is Manukau Harbour. And everything Manukau was originated through the British title and not Tainui. Tainui is in the Australian, Tainui is in this lot, in the debtors. Okay? They're holding on to the debtors of Queen Victoria and Queen Elizabeth's debts. All that Queen Victoria Trust is now forfeited into the King's Bench Court under this flag of authority, with only myself, Maura Hoffman, and Morris Baker to speak properly about this flag. And nobody else is talking contracts, that's what I'm saying, in front of the whole world watching. What I do is Kahu Punga Punga. That's the tribe that the Rokawa and Maniapoto stole their land, then they got booted off it by the other tribes in and around the Taupo region, and also in the Waikato region, booted them back to Maniapoto and get the hell off the land. So the tribes around Kahu Punga Punga comes from the King Koriki line. That's not their maunga, that's not their history, that's not their names, that's not their marae. It's the same with Referefa Manukau's marae at Waiuku. It's got the name Tahuna on it. That's not their marae. That belongs to Referefa Manukau. And the other marae in Maunga Tautori belongs to Tera Waikato Wharehere. So what did you fellows try to think you were doing with the history and steal it? That's why it's getting nowhere and not likely to get anywhere. And it's wearing the bill on this side of Queen Victoria and Queen Elizabeth II against the King and the King's flag for King's business, not Queen's business. And Rapuna Church and all the Iwi Māori bullshit. So Pody, you and Whangaro, up there in Mangamuka land, you're right. They're all bullshit, mate. Don't listen to them. Listen to what this flag says. And it's a British flag. It is not a Maori flag. It's a British flag. So I'm saying this to Cecile Hoods. She's doing our website to go around the world in 250 countries. Two representatives with flags in each of 250 countries. That's 500 members inside this building, the centre of the King's business is in Cornwall Park in Auckland City, inside this building. It's going to be a big building. It's more round than anything, with a stadium and offices and shops and sports grounds and everything in it, and helipad and so forth to fly tourists and business people straight in there for conferences. So that, in the meantime, we're dealing with Britain in Scotland, the land titles in Scotland. I'm familiar with land titles, that's my trade, and land itself, the native lands in Edinburgh, all the native lands in the world. And since Philip, Prince Philip is gone, as a commander-in-chief. I'm going there more or less to take his place in Edinburgh, even with the castle for that matter, with this flag going straight up on that castle and on the magistrate court in Edinburgh and the magistrate court in Westminster and the magistrate and the Westminster Parliament with this flag flying there and in Belfast, Downpatrick, where St. Patrick's buried, it goes there for him and the 8-point star of municipalities and principalities there with him and King William III. It will stand in the Netherlands, it will stand in the World Court this way to represent our partner, King William III, the creator of the Bank of England, the creator of the pound note that we're using, the Maui pound note as levy debtor instrument. You'll notice it's 970 million trillion trillion pound note against all the debtors inside this lot and every other thug pirate in the world that are pirates using this system to steal money and land and birth certificates and natural resources from the real king's common people. And that's what I want to say, people. I'm just trying to get the pound note so you can see what I'm talking about. That going around the world. Where's this book? I can keep those through the wall. I keep doing one more. One more time. Just to explain one more time before Christmas that we are going around the world with this flag in 250 countries with a billion shares each country. Now what we're doing is we're flying the flag in each country, starting with Scotland, England, Ireland, New Zealand, America, Canada, Philippines. For starters. Okay, that's for starters. And we shall use this 970 million trillion trillion pound note here with our current monarch, King Ernest Augustus, Prince Ernest Augustus, or King Ernest Augustus the Fifth. Reigning monarch, oath of office to Westminster. I'm going there to put him in to Westminster to get rid of all those paedophiles and the Queen's thugs and Rothschild banks right out of there with this king. He's the reigning monarch at the moment of Britain, UK, Hanover, Aotearoa, New Zealand, the Pacific Islands, and the Commonwealth countries of the world, and these 250 countries I'm telling you that this flag is going into. Okay, so unfortunately for those people who are flying the flag for the wrong reasons, this flag has no legal effect in anything else other than what I do. Now here's the Maori Deeds of Land Purchases in the North Island of New Zealand, Volume 1, Clear Tower Block. Right? It's got signed Manukau Referefa. Signed, I'm citing this in front of you. Manukau Referefa Manukau, 11th of November, 1862. Okay? Uatawa Block, Pukekohe, Manukau District. Now he hasn't signed with Referefa, only with the Manukau. This is the devious people who put this together. Kua rilo mai kiao na te rokena e rima pauna takitahi maku e nei moni e whakahokia kia ia inarite te utu mō Māua, whenua ko Uetawa, ko Pukekohe, te ingoa nui o Tawa Whenua. Signed, Manukau Rewherewha, Akarana, November 11, 1862, with our block, Pukekohe Manukau District. See, so we've stamped it with the Māuai, standing in London, right there, as my own Wānoa family's memorial, seal of God's earth law, L-O-R-E, truth, deeds of truth law. And this seal with Hongihika and Tera Waikato Whare Here Here Manukau went to England with Thomas Kendall, Bishop, and the flag on the side, other side, this flag here, that inevitably ended up from this seal to this flag. This is 1820, and this is 1834, from this assignment of a contract to go to England to get help from the King. Okay? So Tera Waikato Wharehere Manukau got help from King George the Fourth. There's enough information in there about him, and that extended to his descendant Rewherewha Manukau and King William the Fourth. That gave this flag connecting up that original title, because Rewherewha Manukau couldn't understand English and titles, only Tera Waikato from Cambridge to Cambridge University in London, in England, sorry. So that's how that happens, but I'll get back onto this 250 countries and the fact that there's one of a trillion shares registered here in New Zealand, and the shares are split. I'm redoing the shares on my tidal turbine water money shares. We're using the tidal energy water in the sea as the currency for all the water in the world. We're taking that title under this King's flag of jurisdiction in Westminster. In fact, it'll be that powerful that the EU Parliament will be a dwarfed as a small entity beside what we have got going with the economy and trading straight off with people that'll be common people to the King. And this flag, this flag takes precedence right over the world from British kings. This is a king's consolidated title, was consolidated for this, but they had no brain to stick the commerce together to make this work. I drew all this up myself. I put this together, painstakingly wrote it all up with Mohi Manukau, and he signed it as me, the executor of his trust, and his brother signed it, Tony Manukau, right? Mohi Manukau, and me. And that's the proof that I'm the executor of his trust and his Freemason contracts. Right? Nobody's business to inquire what I do with him as a Freemason. He's not a Ratna minister there. He's a businessman, which is Freemasons are business people that help him put this together and that cargo to make it all work. Right? I've got all that information here to prove. So I'm citing all these things. I'm putting it together carefully for the Internal Affairs and Foreign Affairs to authenticate what I'm saying. All these documents are authenticated already with the chief's signatures. The chiefs are in their own capacity, separate from what I do. They have said it separately on the videos you can hear, apart from the one with Kingi where we're screaming at each other. I didn't have it on, but just as well you would have heard him screaming at me and me screaming at him. But he's got a problem. And he's told me to leave the fuck up a bottle, no key, too late, it's out there. Morris, give it to me so that I can fix up your fucker, Kingy. It's you, the one that duped Manukau's land at Porto. You went in there and put the Tauruan's name as if you're a Tauruan. You see, I know what you did with that name because they're not happy with you using their name on those Manukau land blocks. The Tauruans are on Manukau land blocks. Try and argue with me. But I've got it all here. All those blocks. Helenville blocks, Pahia blocks, Waitangi blocks. I've got the whole lot, Kingi, South Island, Chatham Islands. I've got the whole lot here. And all the treaty claims books, the big thick books are behind here as well, with the crooked stories in it that you had to follow. That's why you keep talking about Rahiri. Rahiri was not a contract person. He has no contract with this land. Only Hori Te Kuri. Only Hori Te Kuri and Referefa Manukau on this book where the receipt is, Kingi. The receipt here. Bundy and them signed the receipt, but they just shut their eyes and signed it to help me along the way. Right? They did that for me to be on my way on what I'm doing. See, because they've got their own ideas. But I'll tell you what, Bundy, don't use this for the wrong reasons, because you'll get in trouble with the Freemasons. I'm tied up in this in Scotland with all the land titles I'm going to, and this is Lobo's titles to Britain on the 10 land blocks he's got back, and more he's going to get back here. He can take the whole of Wokianga back, one shot, if he wanted to. Alright? That's Here Maya Hori Te Kuri. Hori Te Kuri, original owner. Names. You'll notice the names are in lower case, which is a natural person, not in capitals. See, it's not in capitals. They took them as being natural persons. Yet here we've got Referefa Manukau as a commercial landowner. A commercial landowner and Hori Te Kuri as a natural person. And again a natural person. All the titles he's got as in lowercase, natural person. I'm looking at all these titles here, none of your business, but I'm looking at all these titles here. I blew up this one, the deed 79 and the deed 80 of Referefa Manukau, name and capitals. Right there under my finger. It's signed by Manukau and Referefa. This is the mischief that they did. This one's with that fucker papa there. I'm telling you this. And up here in the Maori version, in the native language, only signed Manukau so that they can play around with the Manukau title in that name, Manukau, in Referefa, and play around with it, with the Maori titles. They left the Referefa unsigned. I'll show you one more time. The Referefa in capitals is a commercial landowner and not signed, only signed in the Manukau. Not the Referefa. That's why they screwed around with the Referefa name. They screwed around with it. What I'm holding them to account is for the fraudulent tampering of the Manukau's titles. Okay? The fraudulent tampering of the Manukau titles. Okay? So now we have the titles of the shares. I'll go on the shares now. How that works. That's our economy for the Maui, Powerhouse Group Company in London, as being the first company to start off. We've got a company in Scotland as well. Right, we've got a Powerhouse Group Company there as well. or so in Ireland, Northern Ireland, but I won't go into those just yet. Now this is the Cook Street case book file. I'm authenticating, that's all the land blocks on Cook Street here in this book. In A81B bar 528, that's the land block that Simon Brent Browntree and James Pierce Brown is on. And there's the crooked road going through the middle that caused all the fraud, where they used that road to dump everybody into and discharge it. Discharge the title, okay? So, I noticed that I saw on Facebook that 1933, that's when America became bankrupted. So on Mount Eden Hill in Auckland, it's got a plaque there with a trig, the same Freemason trig on it, Lands and Surveys, Survey General, and 1933, conveniently 1933, under this flag and the Manukau title. Yeah. Everything is pointing to 1862. They said that the Moai was no longer, it was conquered, and now I see they're back. That's backfired. That has backfired by what they were saying about the Moai statue. Gone. That's untrue. All these theories and conspiracies are starting to crumble and get caught up in this life. So now we've got the shares. I'll go in the shares now. The shares are for New Zealand is, and for the rest of the countries are £25 shares. We've got a one-off £25 share for small-time investors. Can be anybody, children, kids, anybody. It's not on the open stock market. I'm keeping it private, in the private of this flag. Nobody's business. I'm putting it under this flag that's locked to the laws of the king inside this book. Inside the book I've got here. It's locked inside this book, the Acts of King William IV, the Acts of King William III, the Acts of King George IV. It's locked inside his laws. William IV, okay? All his acts are on 19 A4 pages of 7 years of acts. That's all we need to go on, right? And you come to this page like this, it's got King George III, 1769, W. Tucker, 1833, Captain James Ready Clendon, 20th of March, 1834. Now I'm going to read this bit about this flag while I'm looking at it, okay? I'm going to read it from where it starts at here. The Britain of the South, that's what they're calling us here, the Britain of the South, to Her Majesty's Dominions, this led to the appointment of a select committee of the House of Commons to collect evidence on the question, and it was then maintained that Captain Cook took possession of the islands in the name of King George III in 1769, and that when New South Wales was declared a portion of the British dominions in 1787, these islands, although not named, were within the proclaimed boundaries as much as Norfolk Island, but that certain acts had occurred since these events which prevented the Queen of England assuming sovereignty. These were King William IV having addressed the New Zealanders as an independent people in 1833, that was with the Tucker paper, 1833, written on that. That's government, crown, paper, printing in Westminster, Britain, UK. And having recognised their national flag in 1834, Captain James Ready Clendon, 20th of March, 1834. There, that's what Pat just said about this flag. End of story. It was fixed. Fixed. Not to be tampered with to make another Declaration of Independence out of, so that the government could screw the hell out of this flag. No. That's backfiring now as fraudulent. So we're using these acts on them, thugs. Anyway, back to the shares. This is how the shares works. My crew, in particular those ones in America, who are finding it very difficult to deal with so many laws and acts and crap stuff that UCC has been demolished by the Pope Francis himself, the thug, right? He says, oh, there's too much crime, so he goes and slams all these Pope stuff up in bits as if it wasn't there in the first place. So now you've got those shares at £25 a share, and a billion shares. Out of those shares are split into preferential shares of £1 million for licensed operators to build the power bridge componentry. That's the turbines, separate from the generators, separate from the steel company, separate from the electrical company, separate from the gas companies, separate from the other bits of the bridge that have been put together in the plans of contracts in each country separated. So that means China will get a contract to build the tidal turbine bridge. South Korea will get a license to build it as well, so they can use their own expertise on the license plans. But all the commerce will come back through our company from the shares to market all the product coming off it, because we know how much is coming off the bridge. We own the bridges in their countries. We own the bridges, and they own the labour and the employment of that, and the product they buy. They buy the product from our invention and our plan that looks like what it looks like online, and no one else is building something quite like that. So we're making claim under the patents of Maui Crown, patents of everything I put online. But the turbines, do not muck around with those turbines, because they are protected under the British and the Scottish government legal documents in Westminster Magistrate Court and Edinburgh Magistrate Court, where I'm going. I'm going into that court, in both courts, to put the history right in there, what I'm just telling you online, first hand. So now we've got the shares running online, and Cecile Hoods will be managing the shares, and your shares are credit as a product of tidal turbine energy, which hasn't happened. That's in the future, and we get a tax credit of about 30% through the British government. We're going through Westminster. It'll help their economy at the same time, and we take those shares individually as being mobile phone tag pay. I'll be setting up a mobile phone tag pay account again, direct to France, and hooked it up. But in the meantime, we'll be manually taking credit cards online through a system that Cecile set up to invest in these products: hydrogen fuel, jet fuel, rocket fuel, electricity from the turbine bridge, and every other business that comes off it. There's plenty of other businesses. I won't go into that. We've got tourism, and you've got fisheries, you've got lots of things happening in the sea. You've got military, you've got operating off the bridges as well. So you've got all that hiring the bridge to fuel and to run their business. In any country we fly to, you land on those bridges and fly them from there to the mainland. But we land and fuel up to go to the next bridge in the world, the other countries. Not on the dry land, always in the sea, for these hydrogen Sabre aircraft that are running on the hydrogen jet fuel. Okay, so that's that. That's the shares for that. You're buying into a future. The other shares is for the fraud business of Cook Street. As soon as we get Cook Street back, the land, and lock those thugs up, and keep, we're keeping the businesses going that we seize the business from, all the business will carry on under this flag jurisdiction, and they'll be better off. They'll be required to join this organization as a shareholder, stakeholder in the business, straight away. The ones who are working there. Otherwise, they'll have to leave. And we don't want them to leave, because their bread and butter living is in that land and the buildings. We're going to put a new building up, and I'm planning to have them in the building while it's going up. So new buildings, portions of the building that are going up. And they'll be going up fast from China, and Alibaba will be putting those buildings up pretty fast. That's who I'm going to get to do. Okay? It's all kit said done. We'll buy the shipping on and ship the whole lot one shot here with other materials inside the ship to make a tonnage load. There'll be plenty of produce going back to